Okay, well, welcome everybody. I see quite a few people have jumped on. There's a few still joining, but we'll go ahead and get started in the interest of making sure we use our time effectively here. My name is Alan Chalker. I am with the Ohio Supercomputer Center, and I'll be leading this webinar. We try to have kind of quarterly type webinars, and along with myself, we've got some colleagues from NorTech, Dominic and Kyle, who are going to be providing the bulk of the content in the webinar. I do want to mention, as you might have heard right when I started, we are recording this webinar, so we will be posting it on the website later. I have muted everybody remotely, but if you do have questions, please ask them. You'll have to kind of unclick your little mute button within WebEx. You're also welcome to ask in chat. Some of our other colleagues will be monitoring the chat as well. So with that, I just want to jump in. The general agenda is that I'm going to give just a few minutes real quickly overview about Open On Demand in case there's anybody listening who really doesn't know much about it. I recognize a lot of the names on here, so I think most of you do know a lot about it. And then I'm going to hand it over to Dominic and Kyle, who are going to tell you a little bit about NorTech, and then the bulk of the presentation will be talking about what they've done with Open On Demand and Open HPC integration at NorTech, and include a live demo. So real quick, On Demand, Open On Demand, it is a easy to install and use platform that provides interactive HPC via a web experience. So it's got built-in file management, command line access, job management and monitoring, and interactive graphical desktops. We really think about things in terms of two categories. One is whether they're interactive apps or whether they're cluster apps. So cluster access are things like file access, managing jobs, SSH, interactive. You can have full desktops, but then also for, in particular, different software packages that might traditionally be accessed via, say, like X11, or might have their own web stack like Jupyter Notebook or RStudio. These are all made accessible and available via on-demand. On-demand, we have a little bit of a challenge figuring out where all it is installed. And so this is one of the things I do ask anybody that's listening to please make sure that we know if you're using this. Let us know. Based upon our RPM logs, we think it's been downloaded about 136 unique U.S. locations, about 70 international locations. We know many of these, and we do have some graphics up on our website that kind of indicates the logos of these companies and institutions. But please, part of what we are being funded by the NSF to do is to expand the community. And so we need to report back to the NSF where the community exists as we know it. So it helps if we can get that information from you. So that's the U.S. locations, and this is the international kind of map that we're aware of. So that's the just two-minute quick overview of Open On Demand. There's a lot more available on our website that you're welcome to look at, and we'll talk at the very end. But with that, I am going to turn it over to Dom and Dominic and Kyle, and I got to figure out how to unmute you guys. There we go. So that Dominic, we should be able to hear you now.
Okay. Can you hear me okay?
We can, yes.
Okay, great. And we have Kyle Gross with also here today. Kyle will be handling some of the questions and doing the live demo. And so we're going to step in some dangerous territory sometimes. You know, everybody in this business knows how live demos can go, but the product has been working well for us, and we've actually done our first production shipment with it. So Then a little background to start with here on Nortech. We've been in the HPC cluster business for about 20 years. We're based out of Burnsville, Minnesota, pretty close to the Mall of America. And we got started in the HPC business. We were a system integrator, and it's just a good way to add more value to the products here. And there's clearly a need. And the last, 5 to 8 years, we've seen a real move of HPC into industry, where it became affordable for the smaller manufacturers to start using it, something other than the the General Motors and Boeings and that kind of thing that, you know, had been traditional users of it. So we can go to the next slide then. So we have both private industry and government customers, and some of that is facilitated through some of our various contracts. And we've established a good relationship with NASA, and actually will be published in the NASA 2020 publication there that talks about spinoff. It's called a spinoff of the NASA technologies. So we actually demoed some of the HPC technology at a recent expo in Washington, D.C. with NASA. So next screen. So we've done clusters a lot more than just the ordinary ones that might reside in a data center, anything from self-cooling racks. The blue one there is what we used in an installation for the Federal Aviation Agency. It's self-cooling cabinets there. We've got ruggedized military type two, like the TAN one there, and quite a variety of different sizes, including some that are just designed for running within an office environment with a lot of noise attenuation in the cabinets and that kind of thing. So it's been really interesting, the customer requests that we get in over the years here. So that makes it fun. It's never the same day after day. Next slide, please. Okay, the one of the things that Nortech maintains is some demonstration clusters that always run the latest hardware. And what that does is, particularly in the industrial sector here, we see people that have been doing their simulation and modeling. A lot of them are doing it on workstations, and they're just running out of bandwidth as they try to increase the fidelity or run more jobs and more, work through their simulation, and that eventually pushes them to take a good look at a dedicated solver, an HPC cluster of some kind. So generally, the way that goes, the engineering staff will see that need, and these are usually mechanical engineers or, some discipline other than computer science engineers, and they just need to get higher fidelity modeling and more jobs through. And it's not unusual to talk to a customer that's taken a step over, and they may have had a disaster where they didn't have high fidelity modeling and simulation, and they got all the way to production and then discovered there's problems with the product, and they may have had a substantial financial loss. And that'll motivate them. But in many cases, they'll take their work, their normal day-to-day work, and run it on our cluster, something that they've been running on workstations up to this point, and look if their time to completion is better, or maybe they can run significantly higher fidelity, that kind of thing, and then they'll build a return on investment argument for their upper management, present that to upper management, and then they'll start out oftentimes with a 4-node cluster or some even smaller than that. And it's very common within about 6 months, they'll be back and start expanding. And we've got plenty of industrial customers that are on their fifth or sixth round of expansion. So it's because they see the return on investment for real in within their own business. So next slide, please. So we had, for years, worked with the ROCS Cluster Management Suite, and then some with the Werewolf Cluster Management Suite, and then we started working with Intel. We were one of the beta sites for the HPC Orchestrator, and that kind of introduced us to the OpenHPC, which is basically an open source, the Intel HPC Orchestrator. They discontinued that, but it was based primarily on the OpenHPC. It got us familiar with the OpenHPC products here and the mission for accomplishment here. And it's we've used it now a lot for our open sourced cluster management suites. If we need to go commercial, and some customers insist on that, we'll usually go with a Bright Cluster Manager or something like that that does support a full, pretty full GUI environment. But we clearly saw a need for open sourced, but making that customer interface to managing that cluster and submitting jobs easier than it has been. Many of the existing customers, particularly if they're not in the university or national labs area, but are maybe an industry or something, they've been running Windows workstations, and they're just not comfortable stepping out into the command line interface. And you know, many of them are using RSM or something like that for remote submission management, for Ansys and different things like that. So they've been pretty used to some kind of GUI interface. So when we discovered what Open On Demand was trying to accomplish here, of making that user interface easier to work with, and you know, even dealing with things like uploading and downloading files so they didn't go have to go out and deal with PuTTY or something like that, that caught our attention. And we had actually talked to some developers prior there to look at maybe attempting this ourselves, but we found that a major portion of the work done by the Open On Demand community here. So at that point, then we had already been using OpenHPC for a while, so we thought we'd see if we could blend those two, and that's what we've accomplished here at this point now. So, next slide, please.
Hey, Dom, your audio all of a sudden got really, really faint.
Oh, is it?
Well, that's better now.
All of a sudden? Okay, I tilted the screen a little bit. Maybe that'll help.
Okay, you're good now.
Okay, good. Okay. So what I know, maybe not all of you are familiar with Open On OpenHPC, so we thought we would talk a little bit about that. I see Carl Schultz is with us today here, so I've met him personally and appreciate his work. And in fact, it's one of his PDFs here that we're going to just take a few pages kind of to tell you the story behind OpenHPC and what it does for you. So if we can switch over to that now, that would be good.
Yeah, no, I apologize. Did you want me to do it, or do you want me to give you a present? I know we talked about this.
I have it here if you want to turn control over.
Yeah, let me give you presenter.
Okay. Let me know when you're seeing it here.
All
The other way, if you're having trouble handing off control here, is just go to page 3 of that PDF.
Oh, I thought you were going to show it. I can show it. Okay, sorry.
Yeah, no, I wasn't sure I had that screen yet here.
Yeah, you've got presenter control right now.
Oh, okay. Let me bring that. Let me see. Are you seeing the PDF?
No. Right now we see your camera feed.
Oh, okay. Let me see. So, what do I have to click here in order to?
The little box that's got like a square with an arrow on it.
Okay.
Bottom.
Right there. Okay. Okay, there we go. Okay. How's that?
Yep, that's it.
Okay. Good. Great. Okay. Good. Sorry about that delay. So this some highlights of the mission here. Basically, it's integrating with RPMs here and basically a repository format here, some of the best practices and common components used in HPC. So, and they've done, I've got to say, one of the best jobs I've seen there. It's proved to be very versatile, and they've taken, some of the best of some of the products like Werewolf, for example, for a provisioner, and done a good job of integrating it in. So a pretty broad community support here. So showing here right now. And this talks about how the project is governed. There's a technical community, and then it's basically a business governing board. So now, so do some high level overviews here. It's, as I was saying, it's basically pre-built ingredients here, and they've got it resides in a repository, and you can use package managers, the standard ones like Yum and Zipper. So it makes it very easy to use compared to some earlier generations that we had worked with. And it's got some things like Singularity built into it and different things like that that we've experimented with also. So see a little bit more here of how things are hierarchical in the software environment there, and we found it to be pretty stable too, which is always important. So a little bit more of the hierarchical overview here, and then you'll see that they've got some predefined recipes here. And we most commonly run, the CentOS 7 Werewolf PBS Pro, but we've done some with Slurm, and we've done some where the OS was SLES, from SUSE, that kind of thing. So a nice variety of recipes, well-documented, and a pretty active community behind it there, which is always important also. Gives you a little bit an idea of the architectural support here. We've only worked within the x86 _64 environment up to this point in time. And then it's starting to attract quite a few users and visitors. So some nice growth there. So it seems to be a very healthy community, and that's always comforting to us. Okay, I'll turn control over to you, Alan, again.
Okay. Yep, I'll grab it back. We'll get back into the slides.
Oop! I just got an error here of a WebEx application not responding here.
Well, we still see you, and we still hear you, so that's good.
Okay. Okay.
Are you Are you seeing the slides? Because I am sharing them now. Oh, well, everybody, we appear to have lost the Nortech folks, so I apologize for that. I see he's still connected, but this is the dangers of a live demo and show here. So we're... We'll see if they can connect. Okay. Oh, yeah, they're connecting back now, I see.
Yeah, we're back.
Okay.
Okay, sorry about that. We had a pretty nasty storm move through here not very long ago, so maybe that's some of the residuals that we're seeing on that. So the so you can hear me okay, correct?
We can hear you fine, yes.
Okay, super. Okay. Okay, so... prior to the Open HPC and Open On Demand, as I was saying earlier, we wanted to go GUI. We had to use a commercial cluster management suite, typically Bright. There can be some pretty significant licensing costs to that. And just Friday morning, we had an hour-long conference call, one of our sales staff and I, with rather large manufacturer based out of Ohio, and they are looking at that balance of do they want to spend their initial acquisition dollars all on hardware, or do they have to allocate some of that for commercial licenses. Now, they are using Fluent, so they're going to have some significant costs with Ansys licenses for Fluent. But they also were looking at, you know, balancing what we're offering with OpenHPC and Open On Demand versus, you know, some of the commercial packages. So it's we're going to see that discussion more and more here. So, but one of the things that using Open On Demand with OpenHPC can do is reduce that dollar shock there that it. Some encounter moving from workstations to HPC and let them, you know, maybe acquire more hardware. Next slide, please. So anyway, one of the beautiful things that Open On Demand does for us here is we have it running in a virtual machine right on the existing cluster head node. That's hardware that would be there anyway. So, next slide. What it's running is a virtual machine run by KVM, and it does have a GUI manager. Give some comfort and ease of administration if the customer gets involved in that. Typically, they wouldn't have to. The Open On Demand image is just another VNFS image. It's a virtual node file system that resides on the head node and is deployed out to the virtual machine for running Open On Demand, just like any of the compute nodes images would be. And so it's managed with all the same tools. There's not a lot of outside management that we had to develop or anything like that. And it's worked out really well so far for us. Next slide, please. So let's see. So the every time the Open On Demand node boots, just like the compute nodes, it Pixie boots the image, and we've learned to do a certain sequencing of bringing things up, so that gives us excellent reliability. The cluster users and the Open On Demand users, we take care of synchronizing them, and that helps in working between the two worlds there. So next slide. Okay.
And we're demo time, right?
Yeah, I think we can here. so.
Okay, I'm going to give you presenter view again.
Okay, hopefully it goes smoother here. Okay.
So you've got that.
Should go here. Go ahead and you should be seeing the dashboard here for Open On Demand now. Are you seeing that, Alan?
Yes, we are.
Okay, super. I'll
tell you what, before you jump into that, Dave just had a quick question for you.
Yeah. Hi, this is Dave Hudak. I'm the PI on the On Demand Awards. So inside your virtual machine, do you have local accounts provisioned for all of your cluster users, or are you pointing back to the same authentication server that the cluster uses?
Those are pointing back to the same as the head node. So they're synced across all those computes and the Open On Demand server.
Okay. So they're all pointing back to the same authentication server.
Yep.
Okay.
Great. Okay. Take it away, Kyle.
Okay, so this is what we've come up with our Open On Demand. We branded it for Nortec with the colors and the logo. Just right off the bat here, we put in our support contact information. So when users need some help with their cluster, it'll bring them to our website where they can request an RMA or open up a ticket or contact us directly. Most of the stuff that we've done are just the access side of things, not the graphical displays. This is just giving our users an interface where they're running the same applications and doing the same tasks, but now through a web browser. So if we open up the terminal, I'll just show you that. Now our Open On Demand server is basically another compute node. We've got a different image that we've assigned to it that allows us to create this custom environment, but it is still just a compute node. So it does, yeah, like Dom said, anytime it boots, it's going to load off that image. So we've got an image stored on the head node that we use. If we SSH out to we can show that we have no hard drive. We're running everything in memory. So we have no hard drive. So every time this, if we take the server down, everything is gone. That's why we create the image. Our home directories are shared out on the NFS. So anything that's saved in the home directory is also out on the head node. So we lose nothing there. One thing that we are going to do in the near future here is job templates. What we're going to do is share those out on the head node. That way, when you create a system template, it'll always be consistent there. As you can see, we've got a system template and user templates currently set up. On our last production cluster that we sent out, they had a list of four or five applications, and we created a template for each of those applications. So as the end user gets the cluster on site, they've already got built-in templates that they can run, just modify locations or resources that they want to use. So it's been a pretty seamless transition for them once they get the cluster on site.
And one thing I might add here is Kyle's told me that customer, after using Open On Demand here, basically all of his users are going to use either Open On Demand or the Ansys RSM.
Correct.
And yeah. That's their connection and interface to the clusters. So they really strongly adopted what you guys have done. So,
yeah, that it removes the need for PuTTY or SCP or maybe a MOBA Xterm, things like that to transfer files. Now they've got one location where they can do everything. They do have ANSYS, so they will use RSM as well. But other than the ANSYS product, everything is going to be run through the Open On Demand. So it makes everything very seamless. As most users here probably already know, they've used On Demand, but we've got file structures where you can go in and upload and download files. So that's another thing that the user really liked. They didn't have to have that third-party application. They could just upload and download their files right from the browser. I think that's pretty much the customization that we've done. Everything else is kind of the basics, the standards within Open On Demand. So I don't know if you want to go into any of the basics here, or if you just wanted to see what we had done for the Open On Demand.
Well, it's not really up to me. It's more what the audience and any participants might be interested in seeing. So I'm sure. Happy to open it up to questions or comments from anybody. We've got, I don't know, about 24 or so people I can see that are participating here. So anybody have any things you'd like to see or hear more about the way Nortec has done this?
Hey, this is Marty from Utah. I just have a question. You were talking about using ANSYS with the RSM. Is there any option, or did you guys consider also including the interactive app ANSYS or for other engineering simulation programs that you might have for your customers?
For Nortec, us, we're trying to stay away from too much customization. It's something, obviously, that our customers can do. At this point, we're just trying to implement what we already have and then use the tools that those third-party applications already have. ANSYS is a pretty good utilities, you know, where you can launch directly from Fluent to the cluster or using their RSM through Workbench, that type of situation. We have not attempted to integrate it yet with Open On Demand.
And we're trying to be a little bit careful there so that we maintain an environment that ANSYS support people can easily understand, if there's an issue or something. We don't want it to be introduced by some modifications that we've implemented.
Yeah, great point. Other questions or comments or concerns?
So I guess I would ask the Nortec folks, are there outstanding features you'd be interested in terms of taking a look at what your customers do with your products and what their workflow looks like? Do you have any guidance or insight as to what would be useful extensions for the platform?
Well, we actually did get some early on feedback. We're still kind of waiting for this first customer to really go through and test. But we did get a few initial things that they were requesting. They're minor, they're small. But one was in this right here, the active jobs, an option to look at completed jobs so that they could look at the history of things that they've mm-hmm. already run. That
yep.
was one thing.
And that is on the roadmap, by the way.
Yeah, it's on the roadmap.
Great.
Okay. Another one for this same page is an auto refresh. That is
a good idea.
Although I'm sure Eric or Morgan are cringing in the background right now.
But I mean, yeah, why not? Interesting. Okay.
Yeah. I just saw there's a few people on chat right now, I think you already answered this, Kyle, a little bit, but the CJ is asking what job scheduler are you using, and I think that you spoke to that a little bit, but can you reiterate? And then I see Carl has chimed in, and Carl, I don't want to put you on the spot, but you are more than welcome to unmute yourself and speak all you want.
Yeah, PBS is the scheduler that we're using. PBS Pro we've used, and PBS Open Source, but we've gone with both of them. But that's typically what we sell, or that's what our customers end up shipping with is PBS, so we do a lot with that. So.
Okay.
So what was Carl's?
Well, Carl just responded and said OpenHPC offers builds of Slurm and PBS.
Ah.
So okay. He was answering the question in chat.
Very good.
But I wanted to let him chime in.
And we have used the Slurm version. They both work great. So.
Yeah. Okay.
Great.
I got
so
one
any
other.
Other go ahead. Go.
I got one other comment from the end users, and they were looking for a way to sort files within the Explorer. That was another thing that was brought up.
Okay.
So being able to click on modified date or size or something like that to
exactly
what you're saying.
Right. You got it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that would make sense.
How do you, I'm just curious, how do you guys intend to handle keeping Open On Demand updated on your client systems? Is it their responsibility? Are you guys going to be doing that? What's your thoughts there?
What we do is with customers, we'll typically they get an initial support package from NORTAC. If they are looking, if they're not comfortable doing the maintaining, and most of them aren't, unless they're a an educational institution or a national lab or something like that. But many of our, particularly industrial customers, they'll purchase block time from us, and that includes a wide range of support. We obviously provide the warranty on the hardware outside of that, but if they're looking for customization, updating, because we see a lot of the commercial software packages, change revisions, and the customers are interested in getting that. So we look at, if there's significant benefit to moving to a new version of Open On Demand, we would look at that much the same as we do with the commercial packages. Just roll it in through it time.
Yeah. And now, Dom, if I can put you a little bit on the spot here, I know just in talking to you offline, this was not something that all of a sudden just, hey, you plopped it on here. There was, I know there's some secret sauce you don't want to spill behind the scenes, so to speak, but there was work involved in this integration.
So some of the most challenging there was taking this and fitting it in the VNFS there and getting that to behave well. It's that kind of thing. It's nothing. There's nothing that we're going to see any, that somebody else with the same skill sets couldn't have accomplished, but just a matter of working through it. And then the other benefit we've got here is we basically insist that the customers here log in remotely when we get clusters fully integrated and installed and run their jobs here. It builds a warm and fuzzies margin of comfort with them, and because we've got a synthetic environment here IT-wise where that cluster, when they're testing it, and then when it ships and is deployed at their site, It's running their DNSs and their IP addresses. None of that changes. So, you know, and what we've gained here, a lot of the feedback that Kyle's talking about from the initial customer here comes from that demo week that we went through, where the customer was running their jobs, and Kyle had developed the templates for the way they were going to use this cluster. And, you know, it gives us a chance to train them. It also builds confidence in them that, you know, this machine is going to indeed meet those return on investment parameters that they told management about, you know, months prior. And it works out well for everybody there. It's, so that's how we got the initial feedback. Now, once it's deployed, I'm sure we'll probably gain some more.
Sure.
And we've already got other potential customers that you know, we've made aware of this, and they're expressing a lot of interest. I think it's you guys saw a need out there in the market, and you know what? And I'm using market in a very general sense here, but just a need there that HPC has had for quite a while here, and you've done a nice job of at least getting a good start here and addressing that. So we appreciated your efforts there.
Sure. Any other questions or comments from anybody on here? Well, hearing none, I just want to put the final slide up, and I appreciate
sorry,
everybody.
I had one question. I was on mute talking to myself. I just had a quick question from the Nortech folks. So I thought it was interesting, you know, if I understand correctly, you've basically VNFSified the install so that you could leverage, you know, the underlying provisioner, which is very cute. I was just wondering, though, if you also considered, or if there are problems associated with, say, you know, just having installed this into a container and deploying that as a web service. Is that something y'all considered, or is it not doable, or what?
Well, it probably would be. One of the things that going the VNFS route, we're using the same tools here for managing the you know, the compute node VNFS, we are the open on demand.
Right.
Or it's not uncommon where we'll have a heterogeneous cluster there where you've got compute nodes and GPU nodes. You know, so we already are dealing with two different images. A third one, you know, it's no big deal to support the open on demand. So it was that one common management tool handling it all was an advantage there. And of course, the attraction there of either a container or, you know, going the virtual machine route there is keeping the cost of the hardware minimum.
Thanks.
Carl, was there anything else while you were on mute earlier that you were trying to say that we didn't get to hear?
No, I'm good. Thank you very much.
Eric or Morgan, do you want to speak anything to containers in general and on demand? You're both on mute, so you have to unmute yourself if you do. Or is that too big of a topic?
I would say it is a fairly big topic. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay, excellent. I do know that, for example, through some of our conversations with NVIDIA, that they're looking at the very least, an internal production deployment of open on demand using containers, which is something that they needed to do because the DGX series hardware that they produce is intended to be A, very container focused, but B, runs on Ubuntu, and our install through source directions are, they continue to be a work in progress, so installing on a fair amount is a challenge if it's not a CentOS or Red Hat In terms of the work that we've done for containerizing, we have sort of toy containers for working with on-demand, but we haven't tried doing anything in production or any kind of really robust integration with identity providers in containers.
We at Nortec have done some work with Singularity, which you know, handles containers within the HPC and OpenHPC environment, but nothing for production yet. But we know at least the basic support for containers is there.
Okay, great. Well, any other questions or from anybody in the audience? And again, if you're trying to ask earlier, you're on mute, you have to unmute yourself or put in the chat. Hearing none, I do want to encourage everybody to stay in touch. So, of course, you can visit the Open On Demand website. Nortec also has a contact page there. We do encourage communications with the community on our Discourse instance. And we do try to have these webinars roughly quarterly or so. So if you have an idea for another topic for the next one, please reach out. That's, you know, how kind of we got this one with Nortec and OpenHPC. And Kyle and Dominic, I really appreciate you taking the time today and sharing with the community this. I think it's really helpful. And
we're really excited that you found our platform useful. That's terrific. Yeah.
And we sure have. That's some nice work you guys have done there, so on your team.
Thank you. I'll pass that along.
Okay.
Well, thank you all for attending and not hearing any further. Appreciate it. Have a great rest of your day, everybody.
Okay.
Thanks.
Bye. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.